Hello everyone! In this video, I want to explain two separating effects for the image. Like this, we have three parts of footage here. Let's watch the videos together. First video, and the second video, and this is the third video. Okay, the first thing we do is place these three videos exactly on top of each other, like this. We divide the screen into different parts according to the subject that is in it. We select the clip that is on the top layer, and in the effect controls, we change the scale to 50. We move it to the corner like this. We select the second video, change its scale to 50 as well, and move it down the screen like this and to the right. Okay. We select the third video. The third video doesn't need scaling, just move it to the left. For more interest, you can zoom in or zoom out on it, like this, okay? To make the work look nicer, we can create a borderline between the two videos. Like this, select the pen tool from the toolbar. From here to here, we draw. If your line is crooked and you can't draw correctly, by holding the control key and clicking the mouse, you can change it like this. Or if you want the line to be straight from top to bottom, hold the shift key while drawing. Okay, we drew this line. Press the V key on the keyboard. In the effect controls under shape, open this drop down and choose stroke. Change this 4 to 20. And we see a white line created like this. If we want to change its thickness higher or lower, change the 20. If you also want to change its color, you can do that from here. We choose white and 20. We apply this created layer across all our layers. We see that it is created. We set the second border line. For this, we need to deselect a layer we previously made. Click in this empty area so that no layer is selected. Then in the pen tools, draw the imaginary line. Just like we did for the first one, press B on the keyboard and drag this across all layers, and that's the result. Okay, we'll take a short break before we go to the second effect. In the meantime, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't, and like the video so it gets more views. Thank you. Here we also have three footages. This footage is the second and the third. Okay, like the first effect, we place three layers on top of each other. When choosing the layer order, be careful about where the subject is located in each image. For example, in this image, the subject is approximately on the left. So we place that on the left. We place the subject of this image on the right side of the frame and this one in the middle. The subject we want in the middle, we put above all the layers and we place these three footages on top of each other, like this. We start our work from the top layer. In effects, we type linear and linear wipe appears. We apply it to the top layer like this. After doing that, in effect controls, from this area we change the numbers, we crop the image, crop its right side as well, we select linear wipe, right click copy and right click paste in this empty area. Okay, change 66 to 240 and press enter like this. Now the middle image is completely done. Let's go to the left and right images. Okay, the right image, we click on it from effect controls. We move the position to the right like this. To remove that white area, we need to crop this layer from the left side. From effects, once again, we apply linear wipe. This time on the second clip. Like this. and in effect controls, we change this number until the whiteness of that area disappears. Select the last layer, move the position to the left, and we see that the subject appears by itself. If you want, you can scale it a bit to zoom it in, like this. Like the first trick, place a colored or white line between the images. For this, select the pen tool and click from this point to here. Because we already gave it a stroke, it has a stroke. But if it didn't have a stroke, go to shape and open this drop down and adjust the amount however you like or change its color here. Okay, after you do this, press the V key on the keyboard and drag this layer onto all the layers like this. Then again, select the pen tool and draw a line from top to bottom like this. As you can see, because we set it up before the brush settings I applied, if you want, you can move the line like this, press the V key on the keyboard and drag this layer onto all the layers as well like this. And that's the result of the work. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, do that now and press the bell so you don't miss the next videos. Goodbye and good luck.